ZMX TV, Zimbabwe leading trending gossip TV. Subscribe to the channel. Remember, guys, to follow us on all our social media platforms: ZMX TV on Instagram, ZMX TV on Facebook, and ZMX TV on our YouTube channel. Welcome to another edition of our ZMX Sports for the love of sports. Today is the 14th of October, 2021, and so. Back to back, and I'm still angry. Because we were supposed to win those two matches and qualify for the World Cup. Taka donated my points. We donated the points. But you see, the under fire Fulton Kanambo lead Zifa leadership has apologized to the nation in the wake of the Warriors' failure to progress to the final round of the 2022 World Cup qualifiers. Zimbabwe were eliminated from the 2022 FIFA World Cup qualifiers after suffering back-to-back defeats to Ghana, which confirmed their elimination from the competition with two matches remaining. Much of the blame for the Warriors' dismissal campaign has been put on the Zifa leadership due to its failure to adequately prepare the team for the qualifiers and its initial plan to fire Croatian coach Loga, who took charge of the first two matches. In a statement, Zifa said, issued an apology to the local football fans. The Zimbabwe Football Association, Zifa, sincerely apologizes to all football stakeholders for the senior national team's back-to-back losses to Ghana and the eventual elimination from the FIFA World Cup 2022 qualifiers, Zifa said in a statement. We fully understand the disappointment that comes with every unfavorable result from the national teams because we know just how much Zimbabweans love and support their team. The local football governing body said it takes responsibility for the team's dismissal show in which they collected a single point in their four matches. Zifa, as the institution responsible for the football in Zimbabwe, therefore takes full responsibility for the Warriors' failure to qualify for the World Cup, irrespective of several impediments that further complicated the journey. In that regard, the association encourages all stakeholders to support the players and desist from insulting the players, secretariat, and the technical team who gave their all a badge on a losing cause. Zifa also cleared the air on the chaotic travel arrangements ahead of Tuesday's reverse fixture against Ghana Tuesday, which saw the Black Stars arriving in the capital before the Warriors, who remained stuck in the West African nation after Saturday's loss. Further, Zifa has received numerous inquiries from stakeholders on why Ghana arrived in Zimbabwe earlier than our own Warriors after the first leg. Their fear was that Zifa had probably not prepared adequately for the two matches, while Ghana flew directly from Ghana to Harare on a government-funded chartered flight. Our Warriors used a commercial flight secured using their association's resources. The flight route used by the Warriors to travel from Accra to Harare was fastest on the earliest possible flight. For the first leg in Ghana, players traveled directly to the match venue to reduce travel distances, which would have affected their preparedness for the match. The Football Association said it was hopeful that the recent return of domestic football would widen the national team selection base as the country looks forward to the AFCON finals to be held in Cameroon in January. Zifa hopes that the return of local football competitions previously suspended due to COVID-19 restrictions will increase national team coaches' selection options. Zifa will take lessons from the two matches and without compromising performance on the remaining World Cup matches, shift attention to the upcoming African Cup of Nations finals. The final two FIFA World Cup 2022 qualifiers will be used to further prepare for the AFCON finals, added the statement. The Warriors will face South Africa away and Ethiopia at home in their final two games of the 2022 World Cup qualifiers. And yeah, so that's the latest here. Zifa in a plan for you. Team Iri Arena plan. We made a mistake by firing Loga. And Loga, Diagambo Siwa Ripo until this whole World Cup situation. And it seems like Numen Mapeza. Anna Plan also, the man is clueless on the Warriors' selection because you know asuna so ziva structure ari kumhanya nayo. Anyway guys, we're gonna have a live show where we're gonna be talking about this and this guy here on Zimek Sports. But as for now, Zifa apologizes to the nation. They're saying, you know what, we are so sorry, you know, takaro wa magame esaya. And you know, out of four matches, Tarango blew out in 1 point. Just imagine, Motona Mega to Tipagaipa. And Gasaga, Mimi Mrozona saying, I tell in the comment section, this is Zimek Sports for the love of sports. I still think that we need to start football on the grassroots level. We need to recruit our final. My 23 Kambo Pins or Warriors team to Mono to Antamba say, because we are relying mostly on people who are now old. Some of these guys are no longer in their form. Saka tufana kutwa go opana adigidiki bachiri kumanya. And they're like, what the South African national team is doing. They're doing it very well, you know, because they're choosing people according to the seriousness, commitment. Kasa nyingere ma players, the player ningi ngawe, player ningi ngasa kwe, player ningi aramba kwe, Katitra gave an wada ku tambira nyika. People who are patriotic about us as Zimbabweans, people who are ready to, you know, to do anything for Zimbabwe, people who are ready to play. And let's recruit our final digga. Let's focus attention on the upcoming soccer stars, our final 23-22 years of age. And iba wangawa I can go more as momo, watambone my experienced players. Let's not rely on the same people each and every time, because most of these guys, they are also on injuries. Saka moto na mega tochika na wewa wakasawe wacho watinga taka temba wacho wawo. Tingista na mo option na kawanda, because we are not building the next generation of the Warriors. We are depending on the same guys over and over again, and we are getting the same results each and every time. And so, put it out in the comment section. This is Zimek Sports for the love of sports. Zifa in a plan, Zifa wanana plan in Boripo. And our first game next year, January, is gonna be versus Senegal. And do game rototi Change Chiro, Kuseri next year foot. And yeah, Dawana Chango Buddha, my first round, like always, and like ku AFCON, Tunongo Buddha in the first round, Tutongo to Kapadin, because Paringa Pasna Choku Mirira, Pen Pasna Change Chibuda Shuni Pabu. And so we need to go back to the drawing board and see Patukanganisa and Patrick Taza and the Tunia Zumba Gazer is a pub before it's too late. And so this is Zimek Sports for the love of sports. You're watching Zimek TV, Zimbabwe leading trending gossip TV. We need a new safer board and a plan about the soccer. We need ex players. Wanana Alois Bunjira, they need to be in Zifa so that they can actually guide. Wanyazo wana kujishakamira si panyadze football, because if you put people who are clueless, who are always all about money and politics, and so we need people who really played football to be part of the Warriors so that wawaruwanu wanukwanisa kututunga mira papa naoze na avuiz. Otherwise chango na batungu ripa jumbo wani yoyo. And so this is Zimek Sports for the love of sports. You're watching Zimek TV, Zimbabwe leading trend gossip TV. Thank you very much for listening and watching. Bless up.